holding.
Yeah, what's up with Blac Chyna?
Apparently she held a woman hostage in a room. Let's find out why. Why
was she accused of holding a woman hostage in her hotel room? Damn, she's got some work done, right?
Ooh, look at her.
Blac Chyna is reportedly involved in a police investigation after it was alleged that she held a woman hostage in her hotel room last month. In a video obtained by The Sun, a woman could be seen leaving outside of a hotel room as she bursts into tears as her friend, who is recording the video, calls for her to come out. Blac Chyna could be seen standing at the door as the woman walks out. According to The Sun, the incident reportedly took place at the Sacramento Sheraton Grand after Chyna allegedly invited the woman and her friend back to her room for some drinks. The woman's friend, Ron Knighton, said, "Everyone was enjoying themselves, the drinks were flowing, and the energy in the suite was real good." He continued to say, "Suddenly, out of nowhere, Chyna just yelled at my friend to shut the fuck up, or she'd beat both our asses." The vibe immediately changed. So at that point, we thought it was best to leave, but when I went to walk out, she shut the door behind me.
That was from the Coke.
Yeah, you think it was the Coke?
That's the Coke. Ain't alcohol, first of all. She had an outburst not too long ago in the airport like that. She just went rampant and told everybody blatantly to shut the fuck up.
Oh, really?
So if you're in a room with her, first of all, y'all all grown. This isn't like a club setting.
Right.
Why are y'all in a room in a hotel suite getting drunk?
Right. And
y'all just having casual conversation in the suite.
The energy in the suite was real good.
First of all, somebody had an anal fissure and went off. I mean, you need to shut the fuck up and continue doing. That's probably why she needed to shut the fuck up, because she needed to finish that threesome.
Right.
Somebody wanted their ass ate, and she was too busy talking and wasn't
right
completing the angolingus part of the
analingus.
The angolingus part of shutting the fuck up. Her mouth should have been centipeding somewhere.
Centipeding. It wasn't until 20 minutes later, other individuals that appeared to be a part of Chyna's team knocked on the door telling her to open up. That's when the woman
was high on cocaine.
Right. That's when the woman walked out of the room emotional as she began to cry. As she apologized, Ron said, "It's not your fault. She's high on cocaine and crazy."
Told you. Have you out there you fucking a mailbox?
You nailed it. Fucking a mailbox?
You'll be so damn horny, you in the mailbox. I have
so cocaine again. Makes you horny.
Yeah.
Is that? I've never heard that. I know weed does.
It depends on certain weed, but coke, I mean, and it depends on your setting. Like, they were in a suite. I think that was more sexual. That was not like a business.
Right. I've heard people say that when they do coke, it makes them think about doing more coke.
Yeah. And your mind just runs and you think about shit.
But I didn't hear anybody say it makes you want to just have sex.
It make you whatever.
But
the
you
mood
always
is.
Hear that when someone gets caught with coke, it's like we're caught in a coke and sex, scandal. You know, it's like
that situation. Hand in hand. She probably was, because coke, when you on coke, it make you talk a lot. And she probably was in one of them moods where she was so coked up, she didn't want to talk. She probably didn't want to hear nothing.
Right.
She was just riding out, and the girl probably was talking too damn much. And in her mind, just shut the fuck up. I'm just trying to ride. And how did you know why did it take you 20 minutes to realize she told you to shut the fuck up?
Right.
It does not take 20 minutes for you to realize someone told you to shut the fuck up. It took you 20 minutes. That means you all were high. She wasn't going to give you no more coke. So now you were insulted.
Yeah.
So the coke ran out and they had to go. And she's not getting no more coke. You got to shut the fuck up. And
she got mad about it.
And kicked their asses out.
Yeah.
And their feelings is hurt because they're not going to get high quality coke anymore.
Right.
They're going to get wet weed.
Wet weed.
That has a Raid on it.
What's a Raid?
Oh, Raid bug spray.
Oh.
Wet weed. You ever heard of wet weed?
Nope. Never have.
Look it up. Wet weed. It had people. Wet weed. It had people hallucinating. Bucking naked somewhere. Hallucinating and.
Damn. Mm-hmm. Bucking naked.
Bucking naked.
That's the best. Bucket naked. Wet weed. Naked.
Pumping and sweating in a shed somewhere.
This altered form of marijuana, referred to the vernacular as wet, illy, or fry, was first reported in the 70s. It can now be procured rather readily. Wet cigarettes are conventional marijuana cigarettes that have been dipped into various fluids or laced with additional substances. And so what is it usually?
Sometimes it'll have sherm, or it'll have like bug spray or different like drugs.
Damn.
Wet weed.